Pastor Preston is my name. I'm the senior pastor and president of Perfect Law Believers Centers. I want to talk to you about marriage in a brief. You know, it's a very sensitive subject. It's that thing that you get a certificate before you start learning and going through the school. You know, it's a good thing and it could be a very bad thing if you don't do it right. I always advise people, I say, marry your friend, because when you marry your friends, you already know the things you're going to deal with in the marriage. And then you already know that they fit you and they match you for where you're going and what you want to become, right? It's very important that we get it straight. A lot of things that goes wrong in today's world as concerning making a choice for marriage, and then we get to mess it up and mess ourselves up. First, we get to say that is it God that said you should marry her and all of all that. So we're saying, what's the will of God? And then you bring all of all that expression that doesn't have a biblical base. Right, in 1 Corinthians chapter number 7 from verse number 36, the Bible tells us, it says, if you have a virgin and then you desire to marry her, I said marry her. If you choose not to marry her, then if you don't marry her, you are not sinning. So it gives us an expression there. That means it says marriage is a choice, and then it's we choose who we want to marry. Okay, but the point is, even though it's a choice, then it's also advisable that we make the right choice. Okay, and then if you read that expression, it tells us that we marry who we desire to marry, right? And that means a marriage is your personal choice that God gets to validate. Of course, you know, anything you want to do, you like to do it right. If you understand mechanics very properly, you know that if you put a round peg on a square holes, it will not fit, and then there'll be trouble, a big trouble in the car or a big trouble in that machine. So a lot of time we say marry people who fit you. That means people who have best of character, have the kind of character that you can cope with, because we understand that he tells us to love who we marry. So in other words, that means who we marry, we should love them, right? That's very interesting, because a lot of time we say, oh, do I love somebody enough to marry them? It's not about loving somebody enough. It's about marrying who fit where you're going to in life, and then you have the capacity to love them. In fact, as a matter of fact, as Christians, we have been called to love everybody. So you should also understand that you must love your spouse. So it's something that I need you to grab properly and take in the right perspective, so you don't mislead yourself, and then at the long run, you do something that begins to cause you a lot of problem. Marriage is not to be endured forever, it's to be enjoyed. But even while we're good, enjoy it, there are many things that we will endure, right? But it's not an endurance all our life, okay? So that's why you look for who is fit you. Well, I'm not saying looking for who is perfect, but I'm saying look for who fits you, the people you can tolerate, okay? Because in Peter, 1 Peter chapter number 3, he says, dwell with the woman according to knowledge, okay? So that means you have to study them, you have to read them, you have to be able to cope with them. And then in Ephesians chapter number 5, he tells us, right, that the woman should submit to the husband, and then the husband should love the wife. Always love the wife, no matter what they do or no matter what happens. So you must ask yourself, all this character that pops out from the woman I want to settle down with, can I tolerate them? Can I just love them when she displays them, while I'm hoping that she's going to change them, right? If you cannot, then don't go in, because if you go in, you're going to be causing yourself a lot of problems, because it's a choice that we make, you see, and God just wants us to be happy. So watch this. The first thing you must desire in a marriage is peace. Right, you must go in for something that you're going to have peace. Without peace, you cannot fulfill God's purpose for your life. Without peace, you cannot pursue your dreams properly. Without peace, you cannot even live a fulfilled life. So you must get in something that gives you peace, so you can be in the best mind to process all the thoughts and all the things that you need to do, and do them right and excellently well. No marriage has been designed that is in God's will to steal you away from the purpose of God for your life. So you must be careful how you join up with someone, right, to want to build a home, and then at the long run, you miss everything that God has called you to do, because there is no reward of marriage in heaven. Marriage is for this hurt. It's to give us peace, to give us comfort, right? So what some of the things I got to show you very closely is this. Number one, that person you want to hook up with your life, do they give you peace? Will you be peaceful with them? Will you have a peace? Will you have peace being with them? Number two, do they bring spice to your life? Okay, because there's a need for fun, that attraction, that playfulness. Can you be excited to have fun with them, even though we're not marrying for primarily for fun? Number three, can you be with them and pursue your dreams and everything that God has called you to do and succeed excellently in them? So if all that will be taken away from your life, then you're most likely making a mistake. Let nobody push you into marriage. Make sure it's something you need to do right. It's something you're ready to do and then you do it right. Okay, you must be mature enough for it. You must be emotionally mature. You must be financially mature. And then you must also know that you've been able to manage your space rightly, and then you can accommodate extra load, if I put it like that, into your space and use that to travel through your journey in life. Glory to God, somebody. So you must get that space very, get this very rightly and drive your life in that regard, so you don't get into a nice thing that causes you problem. Okay, it is God's design for man. It's an institution of God, right? And it's something that will help us fulfill the desire and the will of God for our life. So let's get on what is right for us and not get on what we like. So in marriage, I say this, don't go and look for what you want. That means that attraction, that thing that just appeals to your eyes. Go for what you need. In other words, someone who you have, you could offer everything that their life desires, that their life needs to become better. And someone who also have something that could keep you in the right place of mind, the right peace of mind, so you can achieve all that you need to achieve. All those one things can be brought in. That's the truth. You can enhance anything with money. That's the truth. Or if you change your mindset, you could always get to enjoy and like anything that doesn't appear really right. But you see, attraction cannot sustain a great one. That's what may bring you in, but it cannot sustain. So don't let the old attraction and that whole nice things that drives you in to make you make the wrong decision, and then you get to regret it all your life. So choose what's fit for your journey. Everybody's on a journey in life, and that journey we ought to keep succeeding at every interval. So don't do something that will make your whole journey very difficult, make you seem like you're just dragging when you're supposed to be running with pace and then achieving all that God has designed for your life. Amen. So that's what I wanted to share, and I hope this blessed you in a great deal, and I want you to pass this to someone. Let their life be blessed, right? Help them make the right decision. And lastly, as I close up, what if I've made the wrong decision? What if I'm already in a marriage that's seeming to tear me apart? What if I'm already in a marriage where it's not what I thought it was going to show up to be? The question will be, what do I do? Pray, hear the voice of the Lord, and know the right decision to take. You have a choice to make. Begin to make spiritual surgeries. That means you might be a little bit more patient. You might find the best thing that will work. But the beautiful truth is, whatever the Holy Spirit directs you to do will always provide solution to what you are in presently. There's nothing too big for God to do, but be truthful to say whatever is telling you that you succumb to it. And one beautiful thing I know is, if a man subjects himself to the word and his wife subjects himself to the word, no matter what their compatibility status is, they will always be compatible, because the truth is, the word of God is the different part. The word of God, right? If we become of the word of God, we Bible says we fitly join with Christ. So if the word of God will help us to fitly join with Christ, that means any believer who manifests exactly as the word of God is fit for you. Thank you for listening, and I hope this blessed you a great deal. Amen.